Good morning, y'all. I gotta get started and get moving. Hey, y'all.
Hey, y'all.
Look, Sarah. I gotta get started and get moving. Hey, Martha. Hey, y'all. I gotta get started and get moving because I got things to get to. Hey, y'all. Sweet little Tavina. Ronika. You hear my song playing, Ronika? Listen, y'all. Y'all listen to this song. Y'all hear it? Okay, y'all, let me get to this.
Hey, thank you for saying I'm pretty.
Okay, let me get to this. But first, before I get to this, y'all, we just need to stand in this power, right? We need to stand in our power as we represent and we big ups Kamala Harris, right? Y'all, first of all, we need to big ups all women and how, as women, what we stand in and what we move in and how we keep going no matter what. First of all, let's move on into that. And then we got to double up and big ups black women. And we got to say yes to Kamala Harris, right? Because y'all know, to tell y'all the truth, women be holding it down. And I'm going to really big ups black women because y'all know, black women be holding it down. Like, people should take notes from the way black women be rocking ish out. Just everything, just in every way, like, just so magical, right, y'all? Yes, yes, and yes, right, Soda? I know you feel me, sis. Ooh. Y'all, they got me pumped up this morning. This song got me pumped up. But look, so this will be good for anybody. You see that swoop? Girl, I had to do something because these braids doing a little something different underneath. Don't nobody know though, right? All right, y'all, look. Listen to what I'm saying, because I got faculty meeting, y'all. All right. I wrote in there, for anything to move, you need a force behind it, right, y'all? For anything to move, y'all, I was up meditating this morning and all these thoughts. So I might read a little bit because I was just going as I was writing in my morning pages this morning. Y'all know I call that my morning pages during my meditation, right? So listen, y'all, Kiara, listen to this, because you as a woman and you are powerful, and I want you to hear what I'm saying, and I want us to understand these concepts of power, okay, y'all? We understand these concepts of power. I can't even calm down, okay? Yes, girl, okay, swoop. Y'all, get with my swoop. Okay, listen to what I'm saying. Y'all, quit distracting me. Okay, for anything to move, you need a force behind it. So you need a force behind it pushing it, or you need a force on another side pulling it. And y'all know what? Our thoughts are a force. The energy goes with the mind. Y'all listen to what I'm saying. Take my words and chew on them. Feel what I'm saying. Okay, y'all? Feel what I'm saying. Hold on, let me make sure my Hey Queen's still playing in the background. That's my little background music. Okay. So remember yesterday? Remember yesterday I said that we all have this Simba within us? You remember what I said about we are all more powerful than the situations we go through, right? So let's just stay with that for a minute and see if we can feel this thought. I'm telling you to feel this thought. Feel this thought of this force that is our power, right? Your thoughts, this force, that's your power. And I also want to propose to you all that our relationship to power is at the core of our health. You hear me? Ashe, baby girl. You hear me? So what I'm saying is, I'm proposing to you all, and take a second to think it and feel it. I want to propose to you that our relationship to power is at the core of our health. And I'm going to break that down for y'all. And I'm going to do this real quick. So as I break this down, think about this. We all must become aware. We must become aware, develop, and know this idea of an internal concept of power. The internal concept of power is this ability to generate internal energy and emotional resources. Listen to me. Listen. Y'all, I saw that meme yesterday where it said only black people will say listen and then don't say nothing. Y'all know we'll be like, listen. Okay, y'all, listen. And I'm going to say something. All right, listen. So this ability to generate internal energy and emotional resources. So you've heard me use similar language. Y'all hear me constantly talking about this. When I say things like, in the past, I've said resource yourself. We got to know how to resource ourselves. And we have a pharmacy within. That's exactly what I'm talking about. I'm also referring to the belief in your own self-sufficiency. Y'all, come on, feel what I'm saying right now. This belief in your own self-sufficiency. So, sorry, y'all, I got a call on accident. All right. I got my ringer off too. I don't know why it came through. But anyway, so back to this internal concept of power. All right. This internal concept of power. Think about it for yourself. I want you to take you as the primary subject. Y'all with me? You with me? You the primary subject. So as I'm speaking, just say, what, you know, what does that have to do with me? How does that apply to me? That's all I want you to do right now. So many people, and I almost want to say that most people, have an external concept of power, which is drawn from external resources. These external resources like money, relationships, or situations. Y'all with me? Okay, so let me share an example of how I've seen the external concept of power play out. Because power is the root of the human experience. Power is the root of the human experience, and our attitudes and our belief patterns, no matter if they're positive or negative, are all an extension. They're all an extension of how we define, use, or do not use our power. Do y'all hear what I'm saying? So your attitudes, your belief patterns, the way you think, that force that I was talking about, that force, right? All of that is related to how you define, use, or don't use your power. And honestly, y'all, not one of us is free from power issues. All of us. Let me make sure I say that. All of us at some time experiences some power issues. Y'all hear me? So let's give some examples. So do you know those people who, it may be you or maybe in your own life, by way of their own feelings of inadequacy, blah, blah, blah. Y'all know I got to do that every time. So it may be you or somebody in your life, by way of their own feelings of inadequacy, attempt to gain or maintain control over other people or situations, right? And in this process of coping with feelings of inadequacy or powerlessness, we try to maintain control over people or situations that we believe empower us, right? So y'all, this is about to tap on some of y'all toes, right? For example, a lot of mamas do this, and it goes to the control, or in a relationship, you do this. Okay, I'm gonna just sit that to the side for a second. Or we may be trying to maintain a sense of security in our personal relationships with others, which is a synonym for power, right? It's this idea of trying to control that. Okay, y'all stay with me. Oh, you said you got an ex like that, baby girl. Y'all, come on, stay with me. For real, I want you, look at you. How does this apply to my life? Think about your life. Now, what I was saying about mothers, I have seen this. I've worked with women, and I've worked with mothers and women in situations where really internally they feel inadequate and powerless. So then they're using these external concepts of power to give them, you know, their power. So listen, mothers that display these behaviors out of their own feelings of inadequacies and always looking for an external approval. You know how people are looking for approval externally. And y'all, let me make sure I'm not criticizing any woman or any mama. The only reason I'm sharing this with y'all, because as women, all I want us to do is be better. And all I want us to do is see that Simba within us. All I want us to do is see that internal concept of power and really move and groove with that. Okay, y'all? Let me make sure I make that clear. So going back to the mama. So they're looking for the external approval and having a tremendous fear of being alone, or their self-esteem is based only on their ability to control things. So I've seen that with people where it's almost like it's addictive for them to control some situations or control some things. So for example, like purchasing and shopping or spending money, it's this sense of controlling things, or they use their children. So primarily they're using their children as this way of being able to have power. So in an attempt to keep their children dependent on them, they invest a tremendous amount of time and energy in their children's every single move, right? And when this is done, y'all know what happens? It's like an undermining of the child and their future development as an adult, right? It's like an undermining of their emotional development, spiritual development, just their autonomy overall, because it's almost like they want to make sure that their relationship stays dependent. And then that way they get to maintain this power. Y'all remember what I said about that? Y'all with me? So y'all stay with me. And y'all, this is coming up for me because I've been talking to you about, I have a lot of friends who, or people or clients that just contact me, and they just did not have a healthy relationship with their mom. And y'all know what? All of us need some good mothering. Every single one of us needs some good mothering. And I've learned through the years that it don't even matter the age. You can have somebody that offers you some good mothering that's younger than you. But all of us, y'all, need some good mothering. Because a lot of us didn't have these healthy situations. You may have had a mama, a woman who was mothering you that felt inadequate or didn't feel power. So she brought this over you, right? Okay, y'all get what I'm saying? So essentially, y'all, okay, let me go back to coming with children. Be going off on these tangents. Okay. So to this mother's perspective that's doing these behaviors, she, in her perspective, she is being supportive because she's providing her children with a clean home, you know, food and clothing. And because she actually never felt in control or adequate, the work she's doing is actually draining. So it's draining her. And y'all know what? So naturally, what do you think happens? So naturally, what do you think happens when her children grow up and leave? Y'all with me? Y'all with me? Okay. Many people who lose something, like she's losing her children, they're growing up. But many people who lose something that represents power in their life, like money, a job, a game, or they lose someone in who their sense of self and power is vested, like a spouse, a lover, or like I said, the child or a parent, many people develop a dis-ease in that process. Our relationship to power is at the core of our health, y'all. So essentially, y'all, when it comes to our relationship with energy and with wellness and power, no actual healing can take place until we confront the truth about ourselves. Y'all with me? Y'all stay with me. Seeing and admitting the truth about ourselves, and even this truth about our insecurities and our inadequacies. Y'all with me? Y'all with me? Okay. About our role, we have a role in creating our own problems a lot of times. Y'all with me? Y'all know I'm telling y'all this because I just want us to be the best and the baddest. Now, our role in creating our own problems, they can start with our thoughts. Y'all remember what I said? Our thoughts are our force. And the mind goes, the energy goes where the mind goes. Y'all with me? So with our thoughts, our beliefs about where our power lies, right? Where our powers are, our associations. These things we see as power, right? And y'all know for a lot of women, they see their bodies as power. And that's a whole nother conversation for another day. I ain't even gonna get into that. And how we relate to others, right? It's all vital to our energy and to our healing. Do you hear me? So y'all, we're gonna do a quick activity and then I gotta get off here. So y'all, remember what I said about energy? And energy needs a force. And our thoughts are powerful. And then we need this force to move things. Everybody, bring your hands together like this. First of all, get in touch with your breath. Let me get y'all back to y'all breath. So get your hands together. Let me pull these down. Bring your hands up like that. Look at your wrist. The lines where your wrists are, bring your wrist together. And y'all, I got this from the Qigong master, Robert Ping. Let me say where I got it from. So bring your wrist together. Everybody doing this? Bring your wrist together. And then slowly look at the wrist. Notice the lines. Line those wrists up, and as you bring your hands together, notice that your fingers are the same length, right? Notice your fingers are the same length. Y'all see that? Now go ahead and put one hand down on your lap. Keep one hand up. Now with this one hand up, I want you to close your eyes. So one hand's on your lap, one hand is up. Everybody close your eyes. And with this hand being held up, we're going to tune into that energy, right? So we got this energy, and I want you all to just acknowledge that you have this energy that you control, right? The energy follows the mind. So right now, I want you to take your mind to your fingers, and I want you just to grow your fingers. So everybody feel the fingers growing. This is just in the one hand that we're holding up. The other hand is resting. In that one hand that you're holding up, feel those fingers get longer. Like feel the warmth in them as they keep extending higher and higher and your eyes are closed. Those fingers are going so high, they're growing up and they've touched the ceiling. Keep growing those fingers. It's almost like the fingers are going up past the trees above your house or the place that you're in all the way up to the clouds. Those fingers are growing. They're growing so long that they've extended out into the cosmos. Your fingers are growing so long. You feel that energy? You feel it rise up? Everybody notice the fingers are growing and growing, and then just stop them. Everybody notice your breath. And then I want you to open your eyes. And now I want you to place your hands together. Y'all see that hands longer? I got my wrists together. You just did that. Y'all see that? Right? You get what I'm saying about the energy and the force, right? Hey, if it didn't work with you or you had an opposite, then there's something going on with your energy that we need to talk about, okay, y'all? Because you have that ability to grow it, but it'll come right back. Y'all know it'll come back. Like, we grew that, but it'll come back, bounce back into place. I got to go, y'all. I got faculty meeting. Aw, y'all have a good Wednesday. Y'all play Hey Queen over and over, because big ups to Kamala Harris. And if anybody want to debate about Kamala Harris, I don't want to debate about Kamala Harris. I know that we all have shown up in life and done some work that we probably can say, you know what, now that I look back on that, I would have wished I would have done that different. And if y'all go back and read the story about her being a prosecutor and how her feeling that being a prosecutor would put her at the table to try to change some systems, go ahead and check that out before y'all want to debate about Kamala Harris. I ain't here to debate about Kamala Harris, y'all. Okay, big ups. All right, y'all have a good one.